Thank you. And our next speaker comes to us from Finavia. Mr. Mikko Viinikainen is the Vice President for Sustainability and Environment. So, and Mr. Viinikainen has been working with Finavia since the 1990s. So lots of experience and perspective to the industry.
So, hello everybody, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, greetings from Vantaa, which is a great city and not so far away from here. My name is Mikko Viinikainen. Indeed, I work for Finavia, the airport company in Finland. I've been dealing with environmental matters, both in air transport on the ground and in the air for quite a long time. And I'm pleased to have this opportunity to be on stage as an airport operator representative in a aviation event. Every flight begins at the airport. The airport does matter. My title is Environmental Responsibility of Finavia, the airport operator. And what I'm going to go through is first some geographical issues regarding Finland and the role of air transport in this country. I'm going to talk about responsibility of our company when it comes to running airport infrastructure. I will talk more about carbon issues as well, and then in the end I will touch some data items regarding emissions from air transport itself. So how to find information in Finnish language regarding this topic, which is so much in the media and very often, unfortunately, with false information. Well, Finland. Finland is quite a large country. Flight from Helsinki to the northernmost airport takes 1 hour and 40 minutes. So the aviation does have role in also in the domestic transport. But then if we think about Finland in Europe, we are more or less like an island seen from west or from south. So the only fast means of transport to Europe, Western Europe, is by air. 3 hours to London. Well, one might ask, are we far away from the central points of Europe? But where is the central point of the world in the forthcoming decades? It's more or less in Asia. And if we think about Finland's position on the globe, we are the easternmost European country having a lot of direct flights to Asia. And that means that Finnish airlines and airlines flying through Helsinki Airport are able to have geographically an opportunity to run a Asia-Europe transfer traffic via Helsinki. We don't often think about what is the benefit of that transfer traffic for us as Finns. We wouldn't have such good connections to Europe without the extra number of passengers coming from the east. We have much better connections to Europe than, for example, the Swedes from Stockholm Arlanda Airport, and that is due to the transfer traffic via Helsinki. Therefore, one can say that Finland is in world class when it comes to connectivity, and that's very, very good for our economy. And therefore, to support this transfer traffic, Finavia is putting 1,000 million euros in the development of capacity to serve transfer traffic in Helsinki Airport. The work is ongoing. Some of the pieces of the work has already been taken in use. The next piece is the so-called West Pier in the non-Schengen terminal, coming operational just this month. But the biggest visible change at the airport in Helsinki is inside the blue circle in this map. There used to be the parking house, which is closest to the Terminal 2. But how it looks out at the moment is this. Well, doesn't look so pleasant from the passenger's point of view. Our slogan is smooth traveling. Yes, we do everything we can to provide good services, even though there is this huge mess inside the Terminal 2. But be patient. In less than 3 years' time, it will all change. And the Terminal 2, which is now under construction, will look basically like this. And yes, it looks like one particular building in downtown Helsinki. And yes, the architects are the same. But it doesn't matter, it's going to look fabulous. So, Finavia, government-owned airport company running the infrastructure of one transport mode in this country, what does responsibility mean to us? In the old times, we said that everything we do is actually responsibility towards the society, because we run the infrastructure on behalf of the government. But it's today a lot to do with environmental responsibility, social responsibility, and also financial responsibility. And we have to be efficient in order to be able to do the investments that I just showed you in the previous slides. Environmental work, safety is very paramount in aviation. We have to be in good connection with our neighbors. Airports evidently do cause some environmental impact. We have to have a good employee image. It means that we have to have very good employee conditions as well. And as said, we as an airport operator have a lot of responsibility for Finland's connectivity. Air transport does matter. But then, during the years, I've said that when it comes to environmental issues, airports are the first ones to be accused about aviation's environmental impact. That is basically because we are local. The air transport is easy to attach geographically to the airport. And we are under very, very rigid and detailed environmental permitting processes, which are all public, and everybody can have their say on what they hear, smell, or see. We've said that, yes, the direct impacts of airports, like aircraft noise, water pollution, local air quality, we've taken very good care of that historically, for the reasons I just listed. What's now more and more discussed is the indirect impacts of airport operations. That basically means the carbon emissions which don't have local impact at all. But the thing that is in the media today is the aviation's indirect impact, meaning the CO2 carbon emissions from aircraft providing the transport services. And I've said that, yes, we, as part of the airport community, have been the front runners in reducing carbon emissions in this air transport industry sector, because we've already been used to do a lot with environment because of the historical reasons that we've been the first one to accuse for environmental matters. And indeed, we've seen a lot of discussion about aviation's impact, which very often forgets the benefits of aviation, which Raimund's very well presented in his slides. And from the Finland's point of view, the geographic that I showed in the first of my slides are very, very important. But yes, airports are the front runners in environmental responsibility in this sector, because we've been in this game, let me say, and under scrutiny for such a long time. And we also want to show leadership in order to show the policymakers that this air transport industry sector does care. We do measures voluntarily, not just according to legislation and demand by the environmental authorities. We are active, we are responsible. We set a vision for Finavia's environmental responsibility a few years back, stating that we want to be a carbon neutral airport operator in 2020, and also be a company which is acknowledged by customers, neighbors, and competent authorities. This means we take care of the both indirect impacts and the direct impacts. But as a lot of developments have taken place, we decided that why to wait till 2020, and we've been already a carbon neutral airport company since last year. How have we done that? First, let me say that one of the tools that has helped us in taking this journey is the Airport Carbon Accreditation Scheme, which is developed by our trade union, Airports Council International. So there is a scheme, international one, for airports to follow in their carbon reduction work. And it also includes, for example, a verification, obligatory verification of the carbon footprint of the airport, as well as the reduction of the carbon footprint. What are the measures that we've taken? For example, we use renewable diesel in our diesel fleet. Started with Helsinki Airport buses. Now all our fleet in Lapland airports runs on renewable, and from September this year, all the 21 airports use renewable diesel in the diesel fleet of Finavia. We produce solar electricity for the demand of Helsinki Airport. Some of the sets of solar panels are visible in here. Once the panels on the upper blue box are installed in the next few weeks, this installation is among the 10 biggest in Finland. And it runs, it produces approximately 10% of the demand of the new terminals that have been built under this development program that I showed in the beginning. But there's always emissions left, even though of these measures. We use wind power as electricity, according to the official certificate of origin system. And then the rest of the emissions we have compensated on the voluntary carbon market with very high quality carbon credits generated in projects in Africa, which also produce a lot of local benefits for health and social issues. Therefore, we are indeed able to state that the whole airport network in Finland, when it comes to Finavia's operations, is run carbon neutrally already last year. Then the last topic, let me say, as they say in English, the elephant in the room. Airports represent some 3 to 5% of the CO2 in the air transport industry. And we've taken care of that. The rest 95%, how much is that absolutely in numerical terms? how to find information about it. There is a website generated by the Ministry of Transport, Traficom, Air Navigation Services Finland, Finavia and Finnair. The address is shown up there. Lentoliikenne ja ilmasto.fi. It also has the Finnish version and naturally the English version. Please use this when you try to find information about aviations. So that means aircraft's emissions of carbon. And what are the measures to reduce that? What is the CORSIA system that Raimund's referred to? And please distribute and share this website. It's worth it. All right, how much is a lot? And what are the numbers? I'll just give you two examples, and please find more on your own and make your own judgments about aviation's impact on climate. If we take the energy efficiency first, a good rule of thumb is that energy efficiency is 3 liters of fuel per seat per 100 kilometers. I came here by car. That takes 6 liters per 100 kilometers. And that's 6 liters per seat when I was driving on my own. Another example, average Finn's carbon footprint is something like 11.5 tons of carbon equivalent, CO2 equivalent per year. And one return flight to Brussels represents 3% of that volume of CO2. These are just two examples that you can pick up from the website that I showed to you. So, it's been a pleasure talking to you. Remember, every flight begins at the airport. The airport does matter. Thank you for your interest. And let me thank the organizers and especially the class that has a class of students of Hagahelia behind this event. And I brought some souvenirs for the class students, and they are somewhere in Carmen's good care. So thank you so much, and see you at the airport.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Viinikainen, for a very detailed and interesting presentation. I think we still have a few minutes for questions, if anyone has one.
Was I so comprehensive?
Well, it was really detailed, so thank you for that. Well, we'll just give you another warm round of applause and wish you a nice trip home.